Entities are the way to categorize and organize how you track your time. In this video, you'll learn more about the dimensions you can use for accurate and precise time tracking. Let's talk about the five entities you can use to divide and conquer your time tracking. First up is company. You automatically created your first company when you created a Beebole account. Many organizations will have multiple companies underneath one umbrella. If you've grown through acquisition, it might help to track your time split between different legal entities or branches or even regions. Companies may also be your clients. Create a new company using the Add a Company module and select if it's a branch or client. You can then customize further and define independent settings at the company level. A common use for this is if you work across geographies. Each company can have its own settings for bank holidays, working hours, and other localized settings. Next up is the person level entity. Time is tracked per person, but not necessarily every person you add to Beebole will be tracking time. These could be users tracking their own time, people that have time added on their behalf, managers that are only reviewing the hours of others, or even directors and/or clients who are simply logging in to view reports. Either way, you add people to your Beebole account using the Add a Person module. Define their user group and send them an invitation to join Beebole via their person page. By the way, Beebole only charges you for users that are using the app to track time. Next up is project and subproject, and this is where the power of Beebole really begins. This is only relevant to users of the project tracking mode as opposed to time clock mode. It's totally up to you to determine how best to use these features, but the idea is this. Hours tracked, whether within your own company or for a client, can be divided into projects and/or subprojects. You can add an unlimited number of projects using either the Add a Project module on your home screen or the Projects module on a company page. Every project must belong to a company, which, as we mentioned before, can be your own company, a branch, client, or more. Subprojects are then created via a Projects page. Next up in our list of entities is tasks. While these might seem similar to projects or subprojects, they differ in use. Think of tasks as those universal work types that you make available for your team to use for time tracking. For example, the system already includes the default tasks administration, meetings, and research. You can edit or remove these entirely. Add new tasks via the Tasks module on your Settings page. You can also add tasks that are specific to a certain company, project, or subproject. Bear in mind that if tasks exist, they must be included in a time entry. For our last entity, let's look at absences. Your team is sure to take time away, and how they do it is up to you. With the absences entity, you can configure the different types of time off. Time like leave, PTO, and sickness appear by default, and you can always edit or add to them from the absences panel. As your users log time off, these are the available types of time off that they will be able to choose from. How you set these entities up is up to you. I encourage you to think with the end in mind. What that means is, what types of questions do you find yourself asking about how you spend your time? If you still aren't sure how to get the most from Beebole entities, don't worry. You're welcome to reach out to our Beebole team with your questions even before you sign up. Reach out to support@beebole.com to find out more about the best way to configure Beebole for your company. Thanks for watching.